Why are you doing this when I'm recording? You guys, look what he's doing in my feet. Like, I can't even film this video because, like, he is just biting into me and it hurts. Like, why did he wait till I started filming? Like, he was totally chill just now. He was asleep, actually. Like, he woke up just to do this. Okay, so first of all, yes, my hair is like this now. It's completely different. I don't know what you guys think about it. It's kind of like super different. It's like life is too short to not do crazy stuff to your hair, okay? So yeah, I'm gonna enjoy this for a while. Let's move on. Okay, so in my last video, I showed this little cutie pie in the background. And I purposely did not say anything. I didn't even address her. Just, I was really curious to how you guys would react, what you guys would say about her. So I promised you guys that in my next video, I was going to explain where she comes from, why she's here, and just talk all about her. So let's do that. So this is our latest rescue. She is really curious about this light in front of me right now. Please don't peck at it. So this is Babette, or Lucas. We're not really entirely 100% sure on what she is. If she's a girl, her name will be Babette. And if he is a he, then his name will be Lucas. We've been mostly referring to her as Babette, so that's kind of the name that she has memorized. Unfortunately, her rescue just happened really, really fast. I didn't really like think to pull out my phone to record, but let me tell you guys really quick what happened. So there's this place that I like to go to take walks or just get a little exercise. There's a bunch of ducks and turtles. There's also fish, but I never see those. So I was on a walk, just minding my own business, and I noticed this duck like in the edge of the water. That's not food, cutie pie. That's a hairband. So I noticed this poor baby. I thought maybe she was in trouble, but I just kept walking, you know. Then I came back around to that same spot where I saw her, and I saw her there still. I had to go check it out. I had to go see if she was okay. I didn't really expect her to not be okay, so I didn't pull out my phone to record this. I got close to her and she was shaking. On that particular day, it was really cold and she was wet and shaking. And I thought it was weird that she was really wet, because I know ducks swim in water, but it's really not common to see them wet. They have this like oil gland, and when it gets wet, it distributes oil to all of their feathers. That's why when they're in water, they like their feathers just like are kind of waterproof. And I also noticed like she couldn't really move around. So I picked her up and I saw this. She has a condition in her left foot. As you can see, it's all bent and twisted and like deformed, basically. So she was in the edge of the water because of her foot. She couldn't step up to get out of the water. She was probably in the water for a lot of hours. It was cold and she could have gotten hypothermia. She was definitely in trouble, and at first I thought like she had just broken her leg. So I decided to take her with me, and then I would go get her into a vet to get her leg checked out. So that was the original plan. And I figured, well, it's broken, we can probably rehabilitate her and then come release her again. So that was initially what I intended on doing. So the next day I took her to a vet and he examined her. What we found out was that her leg broke some time ago. and then the bones fused together and healed in that crooked, deformed way. So that's an old injury. If they attempted to fix her up, they would have to re-break the bones, reposition them, and even then there's still no guarantee that the bones would heal correctly. And Taylor is in her little box. So there would have been no guarantee, and it would have been incredibly painful for her, and the recovery would be incredibly long. She's doing just fine right now. There's really no need to put her through all of that. Instead, she is now considered a disabled duck. She can't do a lot of things that normal ducks can do. She can't get in and out of water. She can walk just fine, and sometimes she even like sprints. It's really cute. But because she is limited in a lot of things, she is an indoor duck. She needs a lot of special care, and she needs someone to constantly watch her. If I can't watch her, someone else is watching her. She's never alone, especially not when she's in water. So she can't be released back into the wild. And honestly, I don't think she was ever truly wild. She is way too good with humans. Personally, I think that she had like human owners before, and they could have possibly dumped her there. I don't know, that's just what I think. She's just way too friendly. A wild duck would just not let you do this. A wild duck would not let you carry it, cuddle with you. And she like follows me around the whole house, you guys. Like, actually, let me get to that. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and put her in her little box because I'm sure she's uncomfortable, but she's not gonna say anything about it because she is just so sweet. So I'll be right back. So in my last video where you guys first saw her for the first time, a lot of you guys were wondering why she's in this box. Let me explain. She can't get in or out of it. I place her here at night when I can't watch her anymore because I'm sleeping or whatever. When she's in here, she's sleeping. Unless I'm filming, then she's awake, like being curious and stuff. So it's not a cage. When she's in this little box and she can't get out of it and she can't see me, she cries very, very loud and just throws a fit basically. That's why she was in the background of my last video, because I was filming, it was 3 a.m. it was nighttime. I can't leave her sight or she'll cry, she'll throw a fit. You know, let me do that right now. I'm gonna go ahead and leave to another room and y'all just watch what she does. Like, just wait for it. Saw her trying to jump. Well, not jump, but she was like looking, like measuring the distance, like, can I make this jump? I don't know. So that's the reason why she will probably be in the background of my videos from now on. This is why I think someone dumped her. This is why I think she had human parents before. The next day after we brought her home, she was already following us around like a duckling that imprinted on a human. So if I went to the kitchen, she went to the kitchen right behind me. If I came to the living room, she came to the living room. Okay, so like I said, she's an indoor duck. And you would think that she poops a lot. Like, I was under the belief also that she would poop an incredible amount and all the time. But it's actually not that bad. The only time when she's really, really messy is when she's eating. She makes a mess. But as far as poop goes, it's not that bad. Since she sleeps here at night, I have this blanket under for her always, and she has several of these. So she poops on that during the night. It gets washed and then a new one gets set in there. So that's like as far as the night goes. And then during the day, she is free roaming in the house. She does poop sometimes, but not all the time. I don't mind picking up after her. The house actually gets mopped every day, twice a day sometimes. So it's there's really no smell. She doesn't smell. The house doesn't smell. I actually really have been wanting to try out duck diapers. They apparently sell duck diapers, but I want to try making them myself. So I'm gonna be making some duck diapers for her to wear. From what I've read, they should only wear them about 8 hours out of the day. So that would really be awesome if I don't have to clean up after her poop 8 hours out of the day. So I'm gonna be making her some duck diapers. I don't know if you guys would be interested in seeing that. Almost daily, I place her in a tub with water so that she can swim, and she's really, really happy in there, and she bathes, and it's so adorable. I have to place her in the tub so she can swim, and then when she's done, I take her out because she can't go in or out, but I don't really mind. She eats great. She eats greens, she eats fruit, she loves fruit. I give her seeds, grains, bird feed, pellets. She's just so good at eating. Recently, we discovered some little bugs on her. They could be mites, they could be fleas, I don't know, little tiny bugs. So I had to go buy some medicated powder that gets rid of external parasites in birds and chickens and stuff like that. So I put that on her, and yeah, she has been scratching a lot less. But I think I have to reapply it because she's been like wetting herself, and I think like she got a lot of it off. I also went ahead and applied it into my doves just in case. You know, I didn't really notice these little bugs on her till like 3 or 4 days after she was here with us. Chances are that they might have traveled into my dove's enclosure. So I went ahead and powdered them up too, just in case. As far as the doggies and kitties go, they have already accepted her. I've struggled more with getting them to accept other dogs and cats because they are dogs and cats, but I've noticed like when I bring home non-dogs or cats, the doggies and kitties don't really take long to accept that animal. So introducing her to them was a breeze. So yeah, this is the newest pack member. Yes, she's adorable. Yes, she's super sweet and just cute. But do I think ducks make good pets? Absolutely not. They do not belong indoors. If she could be outdoors, I would rather have her outdoors. If they're indoors, they require a whole bunch of attention. They love attention. If you don't give it to them, they won't be shy about asking for it. They make a mess as far as food goes. they need something big to bathe in. And just they are such a handful. I feel like I have a toddler. Like I'm a mom to a toddler, and all day I'm just like after this toddler, making sure she's not getting into trouble. So if you're watching this and now you want a duck, think twice. To be fair, do I regret it? Absolutely not. I adore her. I would not in a million years give her up for $1 million, a bajillion dollars. Like, she is mine. And I understand she is a long-term commitment. Ducks apparently can live up to 15 years. So she will probably be around for a very long time. And I'm stoked. I'm excited. You guys will be seeing a whole lot more of her in upcoming videos. And yeah, if you have any more questions about her or ducks in general or keeping ducks or anything, leave them down in the comments and I will answer those. And yeah, also don't forget to check out my online store. We sell awesome t-shirts and other stuff, so go check that out. We will talk to you guys in the next video, so have a good day or a good night, and I love you guys. Bye. Say bye, Babette or Lucas. Oh, see, that's her saying goodbye. There's something in my eye. Oh, she's pooping. That's her pooping face. Ready? She... Okay, she's showing off now. So this duck is a lot like Taylor because they both have leg problems. So that right out of the bat really warmed my heart and kind of pushed me towards keeping her here. She reminds me so much of him, and I don't know, I really like to take in like disabled animals that don't really have much of a chance.